Fournier's gangrene is a type of necrotising fasciitis, involving subcutaneous tissue of the external genitalia, especially the scrotum and perineum. It may spread to the thighs, abdominal wall and the chest. Fournier's gangrene occurs more frequently in males, particularly those over the age of 50. Potentially preventable risk factors for Fournier's gangrene include smoking, morbid obesity, and alcohol abuse. Local problems that may result in Fournier's gangrene include local trauma, fistulae, and ischiorectal abscesses. A number of medical conditions associated with the development of Fournier's gangrene include diabetes, cirrhosis, cardiovascular disease, hypertension, renal failure, HIV, and immunosuppression, including chemotherapy. Signs and symptoms of Fournier's gangrene include initially a red plaque developing with edema, blisters may form with cellulitis, and crepitus. And crepitus is caused by the presence of gas-forming bacteria that produce bubbles of gas under the skin. Fournier's gangrene may cause pain, fever, and in untreated and severe cases, it may be fatal. Fournier's gangrene may be caused by either a single or mixed bacterial infection, by bacteria including staphylococci, streptococci, E. coli, bacteroides, Klebsiella, Proteus, and others. So what does Fournier's gangrene look like grossly? Well, this is a cross-section of a scrotum and testis that has been removed by surgical debridement. The scrotum is on the left side of the picture, containing a large abscess that has reached the testis that is on the right side of the picture. This is an interesting image from a patient with Fournier's gangrene, and this is an artery, and as we zoom into the centre of the artery you can see that the red blood cells are sickled, and this is a patient with sickle cell disease, and that in this particular case has contributed to the development of Fournier's gangrene. Histological changes in Fournier's gangrene include abscesses, acute inflammation, and necrosis. And finally, in this area of Fournier's gangrene, amongst the acute inflammatory cells, there are large white empty spaces, and these are gas bubbles, and this is what would cause the crepitus.